Hello my friends, Rune here again. Today I want to try out my Tippmann Stormer. I was just having a look at the detent. Last time I used it, the balls had a tendency to slip over it and roll out the barrel. But the detent looks okay, so I will just put it back in. I will use the MCS Kinetics that my friend Sean gave to me, and I will use Tippmann HPA bottle, 800 PSI output, at least when the tank is fully pressurized, like mine is now. I have measured it, so I know it's the true output pressure. I will use the on-off adapter from Home Defense 24. Florian sent me a couple of different versions, so I thought, okay, let's have a look. On-off here, and it has a pressure gauge there. So, no need for you to see me fiddle putting this in. And here's the Tippmann bottle. It has holder pressure just fine. Bottle says 2800, but the gauge on my compressor said 3000, or just over 3000 PSI. And I trust the compressor more than I do this bottle gauges. So, MCS Kinetics. And I also put a long M16 barrel on it. So I thought, okay, let's see how it will perform with 800 PSI. And then we can try it with the 12 gram adapter. These markers are made for CO2, but you can use HPA in them. And they work just fine with HPA, but the power will not be as high. So, all the modifications I've done, as I can remember, is shimmered the hammer spring and put in a softer valve spring. Otherwise, it's stuck. And also, the velocity screw is adjusted so it don't have any slowing effect on the gas. Yes. So. One moment and you can see how this thing performs. And by the way, I was asked if I could show my aquarium again. And here's the fish swimming around. I have a couple of eels down there also. Not sure if it is visible there. So yeah. Nice hobby. And the temperature today is about 21 degrees Celsius, 68 degrees Fahrenheit. So let's see. Load it up 10 volts. Tippmann bottle. Let's screw it all the way in and also cock the marker safe. And let's see. Output pressure, as I said, 800 PSI, and that is what the gauge say also. So, let's open it up, like so. Off safe. Okey-dokey. 800 PSI, 4.6 gram. Quite loud crack. 275. $274. Water. 274 again. I take one more shot, and I'll need for you to see me shoot 10 balls with the exact same velocity. So, then we can change over to CO2 and see what sort of power it will give with the 12 gram CO2 canister.
.276.
And now, let's see how it works with 12 gram CO2. Same ammo. I loaded up some few more balls. So about 21 degrees Celsius and 4.6 gram. Oh yeah.
320 feet per second.
The other one was 277 at the highest. If I had put an 88 gram CO2 canister here, I think last time I used it, I got 380 feet per second with the same ammo. So bulk fill CO2 is the king for these types of markers. I don't want to shoot these on top of each other, because that will ruin them for sure. They will shatter if hit something hard.
.310.
Just shooting into some old jeans. Jeans are actually very good for stopping bolts.
.319.
Very stable.
.318. .311. .310. .311. .313. .312.
Dropping a little bit.
.306. 306 again.
Going up a bit.
313.
So relatively stable velocity with the C2 canister also. I think I'm soon out of ammo, but let's see. .305. Dropping more. 299. $279. No more ammo. So yeah, as you could see, even the last shot I showed on the video was higher than it was with HPA and 800 PSI output pressure. So, and I dry fired it 4 more times before it wouldn't recock. So, it all depends what you're going to use it for. I need my pliers to get it off. Or something. See if we can just get a bit stuck in these adapters. But super cool marker. Very fun for sure. And it is not that expensive either. Yes. So big thanks to Sean from Less Lethal for Dummies. Make sure you check out his videos. Also make sure to check out homedefense24.com. He sells a whole bunch of cool stuff for all sorts of markers. So yeah. Hope you liked the video. Stay tuned for more videos. Thank you for watching.